So today we're here with 1,000 square metres of technology behind the curtains, or just under 1,000. There's 25 plus pieces of equipment that you're about to see, life-changing equipment, and this is the first, we hope, of a lot more of what we see here, not necessarily on this site, but out and beyond as we grow. We've already Rehab's footprint now serving people with disability from as far as Atherton in Cairns down to Melbourne and as far west as Coonabarabran and Dubbo, hopefully seeing more of this equipment looking after more people and providing more services across the people that we serve.
Did a lot of research myself and one of our OTs. I spent a long time researching the devices that were available globally and those that we knew that we could then have access to here in Australia. And so a lot of these products, like we've got the Hakoma suite, which covers like the Erigo and the Armio powers for their arms, and it covers that whole spectrum of leg from acute right through to sort of a chronic rehab. And then same with the arms, we're covering the fingers, we're covering the wrist, we're covering the shoulder from maybe early rehab in the far corner where it's people that don't have much upper limb function to the device just here, a little bit more function, to the device in front of us, which is even more function. So as somebody changes their ability to move and function as part of their rehab journey, we actually have a device in this centre, in this room, that can cover all options.
When we started to reflect as an organisation on what the last 120 years looked like, we thought it's been a fantastic 120 years. We've done some amazing things for people with amazing staff with amazing results. And then we thought, well, what does the next 120 years look like? Because we are the custodians of something that's very special. So we thought, how do we look forwards and take the organisation and what we do and how we do it to the next 120 years and beyond?
Something that we're incredibly proud of, which will really has no peer, certainly in the Southern Hemisphere. And from what I've seen on my travels, it's up there with anything else that's on offer in the world. But what's it all for? It's for the people, our clients that we service, and for their outcomes.
You have world leading technology, but who is at the centre of the technology? The person. From 1899 to 2022, and the person has remained at the centre of it. And I think the value of the person remains at the centre of it.